And then there's this. The World Health Organization announced today they will examine the risks of holding the Olympics in Brazil after a lot of concern and issues were raised that it could accelerate the spread of the Zika virus. Now, production crews and athletes, and when I say production crews, I mean from our competitor across the street, another TV network, have already expressed fear of traveling to the South American country. There are people who say they will not go. That includes people at our competitor as well as the athletes you see on the screen. Joining me now, Christian Whiten and Kirsten Haglund. And Kirsten, let me ask you, I got to believe that an athlete works their whole life for the chance to go to the Olympics. But when you're looking at the potential to be exposed to this virus versus that lifelong dream, what do you do?
Right. Well, of course, there are millions of athletes that are looking forward to this and have been planning for this, as well as their families, people that are from all over the globe that have made their travel plans, all of that. But really, the risks, I think, and the World Health Organization has agreed up until this point, have been overstated, and that if people, including these athletes, take the right precautions, that they should be fine. If you look at past Olympics, the last time that an Olympics was actually canceled was 1940. That was the outbreak of World War II.
Right.
Okay? The time before that, World War I. So this is not as big of a risk as people are making it out to be. And also, a tropical place like Brazil, they've got other health risks as well. Malaria, dengue, other issues. They've actually got 3 times higher rate of HIV than in the UK. All right, and none of those were reasons to cancel the Olympics.
Well, of course, but you know, with HIV AIDS, you don't have to have sex.
But
you don't,
Zika,
say, you
Zika,
don't say to the
right.
mosquito, let's get together.
No, that but Zika is also a sexually transmitted
as well.
It can
be transmitted
yes.
sexually, absolutely. Let me bring you back into this, Christian. Do we know, if you've been exposed to the virus, does it eventually get out of your system, or is it forevermore you've got it, and should you then have a child with somebody, that child's exposed? Do the doctors know this thing yet?
No, I haven't. I think there's still a lot of clinical information that has to come in. My understanding is you may always have antibodies, but that the actual effects and transmittability goes down. But I think there's still some lack of clarity about that. But that's one of the problems, is that the lack of clarity and certainly the lack of public knowledge. It's one thing to think of the athletes who have a very strong support team and will be in air-conditioned rooms. The South Koreans, I understand, have infused uniforms to prevent them from getting bitten by mosquitoes. But for
with
the thousands,
DDT, of course, no.
Hopefully, it would work in that case.
It would work. Yeah.
But the thousands and thousands of visitors who are going to be there and then will travel back to the United States or to Western Europe, etc., that's a bigger concern.
Let's show again some of the athletes who have said they're not going to go. American cyclist T.J. Van Gardner and Adam Scott, the golfer from Australia. There are other golfers as well. You can see the list right there. But it was our colleagues across the street. NBC is across the street from Fox. There are producers and photographers who are saying they won't go. They will not go, and they've got the rights, NBC, to the Olympics. This is a pretty big problem. Is fear overtaking rational behavior at this point, Kirsten?
I think so. And I think that's why the World Health Organization actually is going and saying, okay, we're going to review this so we can put an official statement out to put everyone's fears to rest. And really what they should be doing is looking logically at it instead of drumming something up potentially for ratings, and really look logically so they can set an example of how to responsibly do it. We've had crises before, health crises where things have been canceled before, SARS in 2003, and then the African Cup of Nations with Ebola, but those were both diseases with high mortality rates. Zika isn't actually about, it doesn't have a mortality rate, right? So this is something we really need to look at logically. In an age where we are a global world, we're going to have events all over the world, we're going to have risk. No events can be 100% safe, and you're actually probably more at risk if you go to the Euro 2016 soccer championship in France because of terrorism than going to the Olympics in Rio.
Were you just shaking your head in agreement, or were you saying no, Christian?
No, and it's not just tabloids in the Drudge Report that are expressing concern. More than 100 doctors who deal with this said, why not put it off? It would be one thing if this were occurring in an advanced country with a well-established public health regimen.
Bingo.
Not happening. It's happening in Brazil. Brazil is a mess. Brazil is in political crisis. Brazil is falling apart.
And they don't have mosquito control.
It would take an international catastrophe to put this off. I mean, this is a gathering of countries. It's not going to happen.
Dispute the issue that there's no mortality. I mean, there are lives that will be shortened dramatically and ruined if you talk about babies who are born to mothers with this virus. This is very serious.
Right. Pregnant women, stay away. People that are, pregnant women should stay away. Health experts have said that. That's common sense.
Got to end it there. Rio is off the visiting for this summer. Watch the Olympics on TV if they can get a crew down there to film it.